let me introduce a research project that I was working on. I was trying to find out why anti-Catholic polemic so often attacks Catholics for their supposed cruelty, and I was wondering what sorts of differences there might be between their discourse, between the discourse of Catholics and Protestants. And so obviously I was interested in their attitudes towards the suffering of others, and the concept of compassion came up. So that led me to take an interest in the way that the expression the bowels of compassion was handled. In the authorized version of the Bible, we've got, but whoso hath this world's good and seeth his brother hath need and shutteth up his bowels of compassion from him, how dwelleth the love of God in him? And in the Douay-Rheims Bible, the word compassion is left out and it just says, shut up his bowels from him. And so I wondered whether there was any particular significance to that and what the significance might be. And I found that Staines argues pretty much the opposite to what I had been supposing, which was that the Catholics were placing less emphasis on the idea of compassion there. He suggests that it was the Protestants who felt uncomfortable with the visceral notion of compassion, and he relates it to the Protestant rejection of the Mass and the real presence of Christ's body and blood in the bread and wine. So I was wondering what the database would have to say about that. Would it confirm Staines's hypothesis? Would we find evidence to the contrary? Let's go into the database and see what it's got to teach us. I'm just going to go straight in and search on a basic search for bowels of compassion. Now we've got a large database here, so we can expect a fair number of results. And okay, yes, we can see we've got 893 records there. I'm going to sort them according to date ascending because I'm interested to know about the frequency over a period of time. In other words, as England became more entrenched in its Protestant reformed identity, did it use the expression bowels of compassion less often? We've got 893 records. There are 25 records per page. The first record is 1547. And the last one on that first page is 1596. So we've got 25 records on the first page out of 893 that are 16th century. And if we carry on to the next page, we can see we've also got 16th century references at the top of the page. Okay, 1597, again 1597, 1599, and then we move on to 1600. So taking that as my cutoff line, we've got 28 records or so out of the total number of 893 results that actually come from the 16th century. Now, even allowing for the increase in printing over that period, it does seem that the expression was actually used more in the 17th century than in the 16th. So that's an interesting finding in itself, and of course I'd want to examine that further, but I'm going to go now quickly into author sorting just to take a look at the results, see how they sort out at that level. It turns out that the very first level result that comes up there is actually a Catholic publication published at St. Omer. So I'm supposing that there are going to be far fewer Catholic results because obviously the mainstream culture was Protestant. So again, I'll take that information and I'll put it into my word processing program so that I can build up a list of the Catholic results and take a look at those in more detail later on. And in this way I will build up several pages of notes, as it were, to help me to process the information that I'm getting on the database. Go back and change the spelling, okay, because there are various spellings. So how about bowels of compassion with two L's? Find out about that. I get 97 records for that. In terms of date, turns out that only the first is 16th century, so an even stronger tendency there to find that the 17th century is where the main preponderance of results turns up. And I keep on keeping on. I keep on looking. I sort by frequency, so that I find that there are 16 results for one particular search, which leads to Ayres' lectures on the Epistle of St. Paul, and I can check all of those results if I want to. On and on, and at a certain point, look what turns up. Devout contemplations expressed in 240 sermons, exactly the text that we started off this whole discussion with. So Fonseca's work, which I've had in my hands for, I don't know, I've had that book for years. I would not have known, would I, really, unless I was reading it every day, that it actually contained that expression. And so the online database has been able to give me information about a book which I have in my own hands, which, unless I were examining it very, very thoroughly, I would not have been able to access. Okay, so obviously I'm going to want to do a search on that and check out the results details, which leads me through to the particular occurrence. And notice that it says God's bowels of compassion, which is interesting. And I'm going to check the context, obviously, a bit more thoroughly. And here we go. Item is going on down the page here. This is the context. I've got the whole text here, remember, in searchable form. So there it is. In doing so, God's bowels of compassion will show themselves tender to thee. Well, clearly, I'm going to be very interested in the particular context, and of course in other contexts in which Catholics have used this particular expression. And I'd like to take a look, of course, at the complete text, so that I'm going to go through and view the entire text. Here we go, view the entire text, and here it comes. All right. It's not only, of course, can I check that expression, bowels of compassion, but I can do searches for other words, find out about the way that this text of Fonseca's deals with subjects like suffering or whatever through using that little search box down at the bottom left. Right. And of course, I can click on the actual page here at the top, and that will take me through to the PDF of the same page. I can actually see the HTML and the PDF together. If I click on the page link, it will take me through to the page as it appears in the book, and I can take a look at that particular passage and that particular sentence and see it all as it was laid out in the original 17th century publication, and at the same time I can see it in its HTML form. I'm kind of played around a little bit with the page there, but the basic point is that we can see the HTML and the PDF, and we can work with them in conjunction. Okay, now in Fonseca, I'm getting that expression, God's bowels of compassion will show themselves tender unto thee, whereas in the King James's Bible, it was about compassion that humans have for each other. So there's a significant difference there, and it's something that I'm going to want to bear in mind and think about when I look at the way that this expression occurs in Catholic works. Okay, so there are several things I need to bear in mind before I carry on from this point. Firstly, devout contemplations, although it is a Catholic text, it was translated for Protestant use, and so the translator himself may have had Catholic sympathies, and it's not really very clear. There's some suggestion that he did. And I need to note that the expression "bowels of compassion" comes from him. It doesn't come from the translator. And effectively, what I'm getting here is, well, it was interesting, but it was a one-off, and it doesn't give me a conclusive result. I need to do some more research. Basically, what I come up with is that other Catholic writers also quite often show the same tendency as Fonseca. In general terms, what I'm finding is that they're emphasizing God's compassion towards humans, not particularly that of humans towards each other, in contrast to the way that Protestant texts talk about compassion. Conclusions. To summarizing the data came into a footnote of the final publication. It ended up being footnote 84, and it listed the 500 17th century works that turned up, the 200 or so other works that used bowels of mercy, and looking at various spellings and lexis, the total coming to about 1,000, compared with about 100 for the 16th century, and most of those occurrences being in Protestant works, and most of those Protestant works being religious texts. If I was doing the search now, I would have probably got more like 1,500 results, and if I were to do the search when the database was finally completed, there might be over 2,000. But the patterns and proportions probably aren't going to change very much over those kinds of large numbers of texts. So it would be surprising if we ended up with a figure very much different from that 97%, which it must be borne in mind that 97% of in Protestant works, but limited to the religious context. So the overwhelming proportion of religious texts that use this expression are actually Protestant works, and only a tiny proportion are Catholic. So even allowing for the smaller Catholic output in terms of religious texts, that we've still got a significant result here. So the visceral associations of bowels with compassion among Protestants, again, in the final publication, I got about half a paragraph out of that and said that its usage was not uncommon in 16th century discourse, but becomes more common during the 17th century, and lists some of the writers who used it, and showed how strongly the expression "bowels." I think in the Douay Rheims Bible too, "bowels" is used there to assume bowels of compassion, and even in Dickens, in A Christmas Carol, Marley is described as a man who wanted bowels, again clearly meaning bowels of compassion. Although there's a word play on the actual bowels. So the expression seems to have been in common use and to have survived in Protestant England at least until the 19th century. And its effect on anti-Catholic polemic would be that because the Catholic tendency is to focus on the compassion of God towards man rather than on compassion between men, we've got a foothold there for anti-Catholic polemic. This also connects with other results which I got, for example, on the expression loving one's enemy. And Fonseca in Devout Contemplations actually says, no man will trust the pity and compassion of an enemy, although elsewhere he says that we should. Clearly, Catholic writing found it difficult to discuss that particular topic. It went against the grain, as it were. Whereas Protestants insist very strongly on compassion and loving one's enemies. So basically, I was able to highlight some discursive reasons underlying Protestant accusations of the Catholics as being uniquely or exceptionally cruel. Okay, so just a few caveats to finish off with then. Firstly, obviously, we shouldn't be relying on the raw results. Ultimately, it's got to come back to text, it's got to come back to the literature, and we should be studying the results carefully, going through the context and so on. Secondly, there are various factors which can affect the data. So that a very basic point would be that more books were published in the 16th, 17th century than in the 16th. Very basic point would be more religious books were published by Protestants than by Catholics. We would have to take those kinds of factors into account in analyzing any data results. And finally, although the database is large enough to be representative, it's not complete. And it is weighted, as it stands, heavily towards first editions, which could be important if you're dealing with a small number of results. For example, if you had 10 results, but one of them had been through 30 editions, that would make a difference to the way that you would want to think about that set of results. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much.